don't deny that I could use some company. All my friends say, honey, just let him be. Now your perfume's stuck on my shirt, and there's an imprint left in my bed. I don't know about you, I'd put you first. I bought some new flowers, they are all dead. First you are in, then you are out, like snow. Hello everybody, what is up and welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, hi, my name is Katie. I live in Orlando and I do all shop with me videos, home decor videos. I love to shop at like Target, Walmart, Dollar Tree, TJ Maxx, Marshalls, any store you could possibly imagine. I love to shop around, show you what's new, tell you about any sales to look out for so that you can be an informed shopper and know what to look for next time you go out shopping. Consider me to be your eyes at the store, kind of like a personal shopper. That's how I like to think of myself. So if you love home decor videos, shopping videos, seeing what is new at all your favorite stores, please make sure you give this video a big thumbs up and make sure you hit the subscribe button down below. And if you want to be informed all four times I post every single week, you get a notification if you hit the notification bell. Today's video is going to be a Dollar Tree shop with me. I haven't done too many videos at the Dollar Tree. I don't really shop at the Dollar Tree that often, if I'm honest. I don't really know why. We don't have one close to my house, so I just don't think to go there that often. When I lived in Massachusetts, I went with my mom all the time. She loves the Dollar Tree, so I'm really excited to be doing more Dollar Tree shop with me videos now that I do 4 videos a week. Today I wanted to come and see what they have for back to school, any potential like fall decor, and I also wanted to check dollar store organization because I have heard the Dollar Tree is the best for organization on a budget. So I wanted to come and check it out for you guys. So if you are excited to see what they have for back to school supplies, potentially fall decor, organization, then just keep watching because we're gonna head into the store right now.
Okay, this is promising. We definitely have some fall florals. They have like a lot of different textures of florals and just a lot of pretty colors. Then I also see some bunches mixed up in here. Dollar Tree is amazing because everything is literally a dollar and I love that. So this is looking promising as far as like fall decor. Woohoo! Yay, I'm excited. Okay, let's go inside. Oh yeah, so many fall florals. Some of them I actually really like. I think I'm gonna pick some of these up, but they just have like so many different varieties and they have like mini sunflowers. Seriously, so many. I see like little pumpkins everywhere. They have these like really cool beaded looking ones. They have these more traditional just like flowers. They also have like non-traditional like blue, and then ones like these, and this is my vibe. I think, I don't know, I think I'm gonna pick some of these up for just a dollar. Like I would be stupid not to. Oh my gosh, these are like the only other fall items I see so far. They have these pumpkins. They're actually pretty heavy. You could easily paint these if you don't like the color, but you have the pumpkin shape ready to go. These are a dollar, of course. And then they also have these little ceramic owls for fall. They also have these tiny little bags of potpourri, and these, which I love, these like tiny hay bales. These are adorable, could easily be used for decor just as like a little layering texture piece. You guys know how much I love doing stuff like that, but I've never seen a hay bale so small. Definitely seems like they're still in the process of putting out fall stuff, so I'm really excited to come back and see more fall decor. Okay, so it definitely seems like the store is in the middle of a transition. I've seen the fall florals, and then when I came in, it's like all back to school, but they also still have a lot of summer stuff. So I do want to show you what they have for back to school because I'm like shook. Like they literally have everything. Totally budget friendly, inexpensive, cheap, whatever word you want to use it. This is probably the best place to come, especially if you have like a big family. Just come here and stock up on everything your kid needs for back to school. Grab the list from Target and then come over here and shop because I can't believe how much stuff they have. Okay, so immediately when I walked in, I just saw this like huge wall. So they do have it like nice and broken up. They have like pens, pencils, highlighters, like a lot of writing items right here. They also have a lot of brand names. So they have like Expo markers. I know teachers always put these on back to school lists, which is so crazy that like, I don't know, I feel like when I was in school, I didn't have to buy the teacher's supplies, but they have these Expo markers. They also have like name brand Crayola crayons and Crayola chalk. They also have a lot of really fun Crayola crayons, like pearl and glitter. Hi, that's so fun. They have mechanical pencils. They have like fun pencils. They have a bunch of different designs. animal print pencils. They have gel pens. They also have like Sharpies and a bunch of different types of pens. How fun are those? Like really fun colored gel pens. They also have mechanical pencils, like I said, in really fun colors. So they just have a bunch of different pens to choose from. These are literally my favorite pencils in the entire world. These Papermate gel pens, they just write so nice and smooth. The blue is perfect. These are my favorite pens. I kind of want to pick some up. I don't really write that much, but you know, just in case I wanted to. They also have more basic packs of pens. So if you need like red pens, if a teacher has that on their list, you could get 8 of them here for $1. They also have it in blue as well. Down here, they have more like black pens. They also have Elmer's glue sticks, a 2-pack right there. Bunch of colored pencils and then more markers. These are specialty like poster markers. They have a bunch of different colors to choose from. And these are actually double-sided. So you get like green on one side, black, purple, black, and then like red and black for $1. They also have a variety of planners that come in this really nice sheet that you could easily just throw into your binder. They have a 64 count of crayons, like so many colors for just $1. That is such a good deal. Okay, these were like all the rage when I was a kid, these like scented markers. So they have these ones, and then they also have scented pens. They have post-it notes. They also have a bunch of like Scotch brand tape. Might be a good place to come and stock up for the upcoming Christmas season. They also have a bunch of glue. Elmer's glue, I didn't even know they had this. They definitely didn't have this when I was a kid. It goes on purple, dries clear, so you can see when it is dry. They have color changing glue, just a bunch of colored glue options. They also have tons of index card options. These ones are kind of like broken up with dividers. Then they just have like plain index cards. They have these ones that come on a ring, and then they also have the colored ones. They also have these types of planners, so just academic planners that come with either like rings or just bound student planner. That's so cute. They have tons of different prints as well, so you're sure to find something that you love. They have hole punch, calculators. They also have scissors. They have locks, so if your child needs a lock for their locker, if they're going into a school with like lockers now. They also have whiteout, a mega pack of glue sticks, and then a bunch of flashcards. So this is awesome if you don't have a kid going back to school, but if your kid is like, you know, going to preschool next year and you want to get a head start, they have all these packs of different flashcards. They have like alphabet ones, math ones, letters, they have Disney ones, princess ones, animals. So there would definitely be one here that your child would gravitate towards. They have this pencil holder that actually has a suction cup on the back, so you might be able to suction it to the inside of your locker. They have ones like this that are perfect for desk storage. We're definitely going to be talking about organization a little bit later in this video, but this is perfect desk storage. They have these dry erase boards that are magnetic, so you could definitely put this inside of your locker or perfect for on your fridge. They have these book bins. These would be good organization for like kids' homework as well, so you could do like completed homework, homework that still needs to be done, so you could do that. Whoa, they have this 5-pack of desk organizers. This is actually perfect for bathroom organization. 5 containers for $1. The little ones you could do like bobby pins, hair ties, hair clips. In the longer one you could do like a comb, and then in the big one you could do other like hair accessories or any like toothpaste, toothbrush, just to organize inside of like a bathroom drawer. But they also have really fun pencil cases. They have a lot of different colors, so I definitely think everyone could find one that they love. Here is another color in that 5 storage set, but these are awesome too. These 3 containers, you could easily use these to organize your spices by category. We're gonna talk about that a little bit later in the video, but keep that in mind that items like these are perfect for organizing spices in your spice cabinet by category. So like everyday spices, Italian, things like that. This set comes in red, yellow, and purple, and then blue, yellow, and green. They have these storage containers as well, which would be perfect for index cards if we're talking about back to school, but would also be perfect for like recipe cards. If you have a lot of written down recipes, this would be perfect for that. So I showed you all of the different like coloring accessories. They have like crayons, markers, colored pencils, everything you could ever imagine. They also have tons of coloring and activity books for all different age ranges, and then all different like characters on them as well. And these are all only $1. They also have these first words and activities, ABC and activities. These are like big activity sheets. So these would be great to use with your kids through the summer to make sure that they are retaining everything. They have these right here, these coloring and activity books. These would be great to take on a plane also if you're planning on like traveling at all this summer. These little sets are perfect and they have a couple different characters to choose from. They have Minnie Mouse and Blue's Clues. They also have the Toy Story one I just showed you. There are more of those little book totes. Really pretty colors. I love the pink, green, and the coral. Those are so pretty. They have some to-go food storage containers, perfect for lunches, that have like built-in ice packs and stuff. This would be perfect for like berries or any sort of like cheese or crackers, maybe even yogurt, things like that. Perfect for a kid's lunch. They have a couple different shapes in that as well. Then they have these like lock top storage containers if your kid had like, I don't know, a salad for lunch or some sort of like sandwich. It has different compartments so that you can separate everything. You could put like a bag of chips on the top and a sandwich on the bottom. They also have these really awesome soup thermoses, perfect for like anyone going back to school or back into the office. These are microwave safe. They do have a vented lid, so you can easily just heat this up. Okay, I'm definitely so curious to hear what you guys have to say about this. So Brian and I have talked so much about like our high school and school experiences, and they like couldn't be more opposite for every single reason. But one of the biggest ones was like lunch, like bringing lunch. So in my school, 90% of people brought their lunches and maybe 10% like got lunch from school. It was like not the norm to like buy your school lunch. You might buy like snacks, like a cookie or a bag of chips, and some days they had pizza, so like more people would get school lunch that day because we had Domino's pizza, but like 90% of people brought their own lunch. For lunches too, we wouldn't just bring like sandwiches. People would bring like salads. I brought like thermoses of like soup that my mom had made, chicken cutlets. Like we would bring like full meals. It was not just like sandwiches. Of course, like tons of people brought sandwiches, but it was also super normal to bring like a full-blown meal. Brian's school though was different in the sense that like his high school was like brand new in a new area, and I grew up in like the oldest part of the country, so my high school was not new. His high school had like a Chick-fil-A in it, a Jamba Juice, which to me is like mind-blowing. I can't even imagine. We had like a vending machine that had ice cream in it. But yeah, so it was definitely like a much different school experience. Definitely let me know down below what was like your school lunch experience, or what was the norm, or like what is it for your kids now, because I'm super curious to see. I feel like now it's like more high schools have like better food options, so a lot of kids do get lunch. But I don't know, I'm just curious. Let me know down below if you brought your lunch or if your kids bring their lunch. I just want to hear like what you guys have to say about it. Okay, back to school. They have these packs of construction paper. My mom definitely bought the store out of these a lot when we were kids. We had so much construction paper. This is fun if you just love to draw or for different projects that your kids might have throughout the year. Just a really good thing to have around. Then they have a bunch of different notebooks. They have like wide ruled, college ruled. They also have composition notebooks. They have like glittery ones, polka dot, ones with like llamas and different animals, polka dots, stripes. So definitely a lot of different designs. Just to show you a few more. Ooh, look at this dinosaur one. That is so adorable. They also have like easy view binder pouch. So again, another like binder accessory. They have a lot of these, which is really awesome. They have those binder pouches in a lot of different designs, a lot of like animals. I feel like that's the one I would have wanted if I was still in school. Here are some binders. These are more of like the floppy binders. I guess if you need one for every subject, these ones are okay. I liked the binders that like fully zipped shut. I don't even know if they still make those. I've been out of school for a long time, but they have some binders here. They also have binders in a lot of different patterns as well if you don't want solids. So here's just a look at some of the patterns that they have. And then here they have the more solid binders. I definitely prefer these ones a lot more. I can't believe these are only a dollar. That's like such a good deal. They do have designs as well as solid colors. Honestly, this is a steal, a dollar for these like hard top binders. They do have the binder dividers if you have to like divide the binders up into different sections to be more organized. They have those in a couple different colors. They also have pocket portfolios to like protect documents or for like different projects that your kids might have as well. This is honestly an amazing option for back to school shopping. Everything is super inexpensive. You'd be able to literally find everything here. They've had everything here that I've seen at other stores and then some. So I would definitely check out Dollar Tree if you're looking for back to school items. They also have a lot of classroom stuff for teachers. That's actually what inspired me to film this video, because someone messaged me and said that people go crazy for this stuff. So I wanted to come and find it for you guys so you can know what they have in the store and what to look for next time you go to the Dollar Tree. Okay, so here are some like great classroom supplies for teachers. So they have different borders. They have a traditional like alphabet one. They also have this one that's like dinosaur alphabet. They have this one which is like cursive letters. And then this beachy alphabet one. So a bunch of options there for wall borders as far as like the alphabet goes. They also have a bunch of these educational posters. So this one is like, what is a noun? What is an adjective? And they're these really adorable like crime stopping scenes for educational posters. This would be perfect if you are an English teacher. They also have this one, which is like a math related one. So it's like 100 pencils, count to 100. And then also how to count by twos. They have this science one, which is a plant cell as well as an animal cell. And then all the different parts of the cell. Honestly, I probably should hang this in my house because I don't even know. I never took biology. And then here is another one, which is like ABCs, patterns with fruit and ordinal numbers. There is this one that's community helpers and then STEAM careers. Just shows a bunch of different like careers that they could possibly want to do. And maybe you could do a day where you like talk about all the different ones, or if they have like, you know, parents that come in and like talk about their jobs. I don't know if people still do that. Here is another one about careers. This one says like astronaut right here, which is like super relevant to a lot of what is going on in like the country right now with like the race to space. These cute ones that say learning you can take anywhere and every day is an adventure. And these are just big posters that open up. More math ones that are like multiplication and division as well as math symbols. Another English one that's like the writing process and proofreading reminders. Oh my gosh, this is amazing. They literally have a million different types. They also have worksheet sets. So this comes with 38 designs and it comes in like every single subject. So like math, English, more math, alphabet and numbers, practice shapes, addition and subtraction. So there are tons of options for worksheets as well. They do have more wall borders, so you could like border your border. They have this glittery gold one. They also have glittery green. They have this really like cute and trendy tie-dye one, silver glitter, black and white polka dot, which is adorable. They also have this red gingham one. This would be perfect for the fall. They have this sun with umbrellas that would be perfect for the spring. They have this one with all the planets on it, as well as red glitter. And a lot of the glitter ones would be perfect for the holidays as well. They have yellow glitter with stars, rainbow, which is so pretty. Another kind of rainbow one that is also holographic. And then a rocket shape one. They also sell packs of die cut letters and numbers, so save yourself the struggle of trying to make them yourself. They come in a bunch of different colors, so like different shades of blue, green, purple pattern, yellow, just so many different options. Some are like stripes, some are solid. They also have these pointers right here that look like Mickey Mouse's hand, which I think is super adorable. You could totally put together like a Minnie or Mickey Mouse inspired classroom with this like polka dotted border using like red and black die cut letters, and then some of the other activity books that they have. I think you could make a really cute Disney classroom. They do also have lots of sticker book options for students as well, and you do get 352 stickers in each pack for $1. If you are a teacher, this is an amazing place to come and look for classroom supplies. Next up, I want to talk a little bit about Dollar Tree organization. They have some amazing products here for a dollar a piece. If you're just organizing the insides of your drawers or your cabinets and you don't care about the aesthetic, honestly, this stuff is so cute and perfect for organizing different parts of your house. So I'm going to show you what they have and kind of tell you what you could use them for or what I might use them for. Okay, so right here they have these caddies, perfect for cleaning supplies, of course, but these would also be really good for art supplies, or you could use them for, if you're like Brian and I, we buy a lot of extras, like whenever we find shampoos and conditioners on sale. So it's be a great place to just put all that stuff, like extra shampoo, extra conditioner, body washes, bars of soap, razor heads, things like that. That is something that these could be used for. A wire basket like this would be perfect for in your pantry. We would use this for like mini potatoes, avocados, onions, maybe even like cherries, things that don't necessarily have to be refrigerated. This would be really cute on your counter if you wanted to do like cherries and then a little bowl for the pits next to it. You could also use this for like spices. We have a lot of seasoning packets that we like to pick up from the farmer's market, little like dip packets, instant seasoning packets for like chicken or poultry. We love those and this is a great use for them. We have so many, so this basket would be a great way to keep them organized. if you are weird like me and have a million seasoning packets. Then they have these dish drying racks, but there's a lot of ways you could use these. For instance, if you have like shower products that you don't use every shower and you don't like to keep in your shower, you just like to take it in and then need somewhere else to put it and it could potentially be wet, this would be a really great place to put it because it has the holes in the bottom. So what you could do is put a dish drying rack underneath this and then put it under your sink. And then if you use like a sugar scrub or some sort of like face mask or hair mask, like I said, that you don't want to keep in the shower all the time, even if it's still wet, you could easily just store it back under the sink and it would just, you know, dry onto the drying rack, and that would make this a great under sink storage solution. Right here they also have these like silverware dividers. These could also be used in your bathroom. You could do like your toothbrush, toothpaste, a razor, any other item that you use like that. This could be perfect for in the drawer. It's super low profile, so it would fit into most drawers, and that is another way you could use this. A little alternative way, you could put like extra razor heads right here or maybe elastics. So many uses for things like these, and they are all a dollar. They have these little baskets right here, these little blue baskets. These you get 3 for a dollar. What I would use these for is in my spice cabinet. We had our cabinets all organized by Megan from Loving Life as Megan. If you haven't seen those videos, they will be linked down below. But she did something similar with something like this, where she categorized our spices by like type. So like Italian spices, and then more like, I don't know, Spanish influenced spices, and then everyday spices in little baskets like this, where I could easily just pull it out and I have all the spices I would need for that specific meal, and they're just way more organized. So that is something you could use these for. You could do the same with this little organizer basket. I think this is meant for napkins, but you could easily use it for that. I feel like something like this would be better because it's more sturdy. I feel like with the squares in this, the spices might like fall over, but these and these are great for organizing spice cabinets. You could also put little spice packets in here. These two little containers would be perfect for your bathroom for small items, hair elastic, bobby pins, maybe little hair clips. If you have like a daughter who has a lot of tiny hair accessories, this would be perfect for something like that. They do have larger baskets if you are looking for a storage solution for maybe like a child's play area or for dog toys. These baskets you could easily store a bunch of stuff in and then just pull them out when you need them and put them away when you don't. This is a great solution for that for a dollar. They do have a bunch of different colors, so you could even like color coordinate if you have a bunch of different kids, or for different types of activities like crafts in red, building blocks in green, books in blue, something like that, just to give you an idea. Over in the kitchen section, they have these brand name Rubbermaid take along to go containers. These are really good quality. They are microwave and dishwasher safe, and you can get 2 for a dollar. And they literally have every shape and size you could ever imagine. So if you're trying to build up your to go container or food container stockpile, Dollar Tree is definitely the place to come. They literally have millions and a bunch of different options for colors too. If you don't like mint, they have blue or red. They have so many.
Alrighty, you guys, I just hit myself in the face. Alrighty, you guys, well, that is gonna be it for me today. I really hope that you enjoyed me shopping at the Dollar Tree. It was so fun seeing what they had for back to school, and all of the teacher stuff is really cool. I'm not a teacher. I aspired to be a teacher. I almost went to school for early childhood education, fun fact, but then I changed my mind at the last second and went for hospitality because I wanted to work at Disney. And thank God I did, or else I wouldn't be sitting here right now. But like I was saying, I hope that you guys enjoyed today's video. Today's questions with Katie is coming at you from Marilyn, and she asked, my question is, how do you actually buy for yourself, and do you have a budget? Great question, Marilyn. I'm sure a lot of people are wondering this. So how do I buy for myself? To be honest, I kind of just buy little things here and there, and also I don't really shop that much unless I am doing a shop and decorate with me for like a different area of our apartment. So I've been trying to save money in between because it is very expensive to furnish and decorate a house, so I've been taking it one room at a time. I don't buy like 99% of the stuff that I show on this channel, probably even more than that, because I shop so much and there are more trips than not where I leave with nothing. Sometimes I will buy something if I think that maybe I won't find it again, and then if I get home and I can't find a use for it, or I decide I don't want it, I will return it. Buy now, decide later. As far as a budget goes, I don't really have a budget. I kind of manage my own money, so I know like, oh, I can spend this much, or I'd like to spend this much, or I don't want to spend more than this much. But there's not really any rhyme or reason to it as of right now. I just kind of buy the things that I love, return them if I end up not being able to use them or if they don't fit in the space that I was anticipating them for. But I definitely don't purchase as much stuff as you might think. I feel like a lot of people would be surprised. I don't have like a lot of clutter. So that is the answer to your question. I just shop, I buy stuff that I really, really like, and then I return stuff if it doesn't work out, and I just budget appropriately. I know how much I can spend every month. It's not like a set amount, it kind of changes. YouTube money is like very fluid. It's kind of changes every single month, especially because my channel is growing, thankfully to you all. But with that YouTube money, I kind of like have a different budget every single month, so it just kind of depends. In our relationship, I am definitely the saver and Brian is the spender for sure. I feel like I'm really, really good at saving money. I had a great savings when we first met, and that's why I was able to just work on my YouTube while I was waiting for Disney to call me back, and then I was able to say no to Disney. So being a good saver has really helped me out a lot. So I definitely recommend to you to try as much as you can to save your money. I'll give you a saving money tip. This is like my favorite thing to do. So every single time I open my bank app, which is pretty frequently, let's say I have like $36 in my checking account, for instance, I would take the $6 and put it in my savings account. Because like six, five, whatever dollars here and there, you're not gonna notice, but it really adds up a ton. So that is what I do, one way I save money. But that is gonna be it for me. If you haven't yet, please make sure you give this video a big thumbs up, hit the subscribe button down below, and I will see you next time. Bye, guys.